Chapter 4, A Hand in the Night. That night, we ordered pizza for dinner and had a picnic on the living room floor. Most of our plates were still in boxes, and we were too tired to find them. "We'll save Mrs. Cole's lasagna for tomorrow," Mom said, and I secretly smiled. After dinner, I went to bed earlier than usual. As I walked into my bedroom, I tapped the wall like Desmond had done. Nothing happened. I laughed to myself. What did I think was going to happen? Then I heard it. Tap, tap, tap. I covered my mouth with my hand and stood still, listening hard. I waited, as stiff as a statue, but the wall was quiet. Finally, I let myself breathe again. It's just my imagination, I thought. Not only that, I was dog tired. I climbed into my bed and read a few pages of my favorite book. But even that couldn't keep me awake. I fell fast asleep with the lights on. I was freezing when I woke up. My eyes popped open, and I looked around the pitch-black room. I wasn't even sure where I was at first. Then I remembered. I was in my new room. But why is it colder than outer space? I thought. And who turned off the lights? I blew out a huge breath of air, just like Desmond had done. In the darkness, my breath became a fuzzy white cloud that floated around my room. That's not right. So I did Desmond's next trick. I put my finger in my mouth and held it up. Bright blue sparks shot out from my finger, and shockwaves ran through my body. The lights started flashing by themselves, and when I saw my reflection in the mirror, I looked like a bolt of lightning had hit my head. I sat there in bed, frozen with fear. That's when I heard a cracking sound coming from the walls. I dove under the covers. They were my only protection. Then something touched me. It was a hand! Andres? Mom's voice was soft. I peeked from under the blanket, and my heart skipped a beat. Mom was standing over my bed. She sat down. You were having a bad dream. She picked the book off my bed and put it on the night table. Then she leaned over and kissed me on the forehead. Go back to sleep, and I'll turn off the light. Okay, I said. Good night, Mom. Good night, mi hijo. Sure, it's embarrassing that Mom had to tuck me in like a little kid, but after those crazy things happened, I did not mind at all.